All right, we came out of Sweetwater Marina last night. We're gonna fish today with Captain Lane Zimmer, staying here at Captain Jack's place. And boy, March weather can be absolutely crazy. 3 days ago it was 84 degrees. This morning it's in the mid 40s. We had a cold front come through. So Captain Lane's like, look, sleep in, it's real cold. So we're gonna wait to 8 o'clock this morning. We're gonna head out and see what's happening. We're fishing a day after our front in March after it was really hot. So tough conditions. Have no clue what we're gonna find out there. We're gonna find out pretty soon, but thank goodness we got a good night's sleep, because I have a feeling maybe a long day.
Captioning is brought to you by Busby Modular Tackle Storage. Customizable internal bins allow you to personalize your tackle box, featuring a waterproof and airtight gasket which makes it float. Secured with stainless steel hinges and latches, industrial strength materials ensure this box is built to last. Get yours today at busby.com.
Being that it was a pretty cold start to the morning, Captain Lane decided to pick us up right around 8 o'clock at Sweetwater Marina, and our plan was to go catch some redfish early. Well, the kiss of death happened. On my very first cast, I catch about a 30-inch redfish, and we're like, wow, this is gonna be good, even in this very strong wind and muddy water we have. After that, it was crickets. One bite, we moved around, didn't catch any more redfish, and then we started fishing for speckled trout. And we did that, and we picked up one trout here, one trout there, but the action wasn't fast and furious. So we went to a spot where Captain Lane knew there were speckled trout. He's been catching them there. Even though the water's been very muddy, we go to this spot, there's bait, and we start putting speckled trout in the boat, and our great day begins at this point. There he is.
All right.
There, we got one. There we go.
Finally got that monkey off your back.
Yeah. Let's just see what we have here first. See if we have enough to get a monkey off my back here.
I think you do.
I think I've got a keeper.
Oh, yeah, I think you do.
Oh, I think I've got a keeper. Monkey is off the back. We can start now. Just drifting around, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to just go wait for things to warm up a little bit. Water temperature is 56 degrees this morning. Surprisingly, the water is not all that dirty. We moved to this windward side over here and it's not that dirty, but hopefully as it warms up, we're gonna catch a few more fish. It is really cold. The wind in Bay Gardein was blowing 22 miles an hour probably 45 minutes ago. So we're dealing with some tough conditions, but there's fish here in Delacroix and we're gonna try to find them. Bud?
Went to touch the trolling motor and he was waiting for me.
Waiting for you?
Uh-huh. He's eyeballing me like, oh yeah, you mess up and touch that trolling motor where you ain't paying attention.
Well, I'm supposed to not look at my cork. If I not look at my cork, then I'm usually doing a little bit better. Nice fish.
Pretty fish.
One thing about Delacroix this time of year, when you get in the late winter and early spring, there's some nice fish on the inside.
Take a look, he's been sitting on the bottom. He's got belly full of leeches. They kind of just...
Yeah, we'll show you that.
Kind of just chilling on the bottom right now. Everything's cold.
That's what those leeches look like. You can look right on the bottom here. And we always talk about reading fish. And you can see all these leeches on the bottom, which means these fish are just sitting on the bottom, waiting for that water temperature to warm up. Now, how much water are we in here, Lane?
About 3 feet.
So we're in about 3 feet of water, so fishing with a cork, you know, they don't have to come very far off the bottom, but when you see those leeches on the bottom of these fish, you know they're not really, really active, so you're gonna have to make a lot of casts.
have one more right here.
There's another one.
All right.
So what's holding these fish here, Lane? I mean, we're in just in a bay. You said they had some bait in here, but what, I mean, they just seem to be all over the place.
One of the only spots that's got a little bit of grass on the bottom right now. So as we've been passing the jigs, you know, every now and again we come up with a little piece of grass, and I think that's what they're kind of holding in.
Yep. Another one with another leech, but not bad. And let me tell you, this is the worst possible, and we just kind of set this trip up, but this is not, it just goes to show you the number of fish that we have here in Delacroix. And, you know, Wayne, you were actually fishing on the other side of the river and decided to move over here to St. Bernard because the fishing is just so good.
Yep, absolutely.
It's, I mean, you got a lot of options. The redfish bite's good, the trout bite's good, and this is just a really, really good spot. And when you can catch fish on a day like this, right after a cold front comes through, that's pretty good.
Yeah, there you go.
That's a good fish.
Good job, buddy. One of the things, we've had hurricanes that came through here in the fall. We had some really harsh weather come through, winter weather, a few weeks ago. And a lot of these places are normally, you talked about grass. Mm-hmm. These places, Lane, are normally full of grass. But right now,
everything's kind of bare right now.
It's kind of bare, which changes things a little bit. Ooh, but look at the size of that trout. I mean, that's a pretty fish right there. That is a beautiful speckled trout.
Picture fish?
That's a picture fish there. What I want you to do is look at this bait in this water. And you can see you've got about 4 inches, maybe, of visibility. That's a lime truce bait. It's a bright bait. And there's barely any visibility in there. And it's dirty. And that's, Wayne, that's one of the things that Captain Wayne talked about, is the fact that if you know you have an area that's got some bait and it's got the grass on the bottom, these fish have been hitting in this dirty water. And this is dirty water. Most people would pass this up.
Yeah, as long as the fish have something to eat, that's gonna trump watercolor. If they in here eating, they don't care what it looks like, they eat.
So yeah, don't let this watercolor scare you away, because that is not trout green water we're fishing in right now, I can assure you.
Like this?
There's one, another one.
There you go.
Yep. Two in a row. So Wayne, we've been fishing with the Deathgrip Jigheads now for a while. What made you do the Deathgrips?
Well, we came up with the Deathgrip because a lot of the stuff out there just didn't keep the plastic up to the top of the jig head like we wanted it. You know, especially with us guiding like this, trying to chase 3 or 4 customers around the boat. Well, you know, a customer goes, oh, well, this done slid down and this bait's all messed up. And it's a lot of work chasing around, especially when you're on some good fish. So we wanted something that wanted, you know, to keep it on the hook, make sure it doesn't go anywhere, and it'll help your bait last longer. So that's how we come up with it.
Yeah, and you know, one of the things, it keeps the bait on, but the other thing about the hook itself is how sharp it is. I mean, the hook is really, really sharp.
Yeah, we pay a premium for these hooks. That's Mustad Ultra Point hooks. So we based it on a good hook. We didn't want to cheap out on the hook. And everything about it is just the best we can do.
And I can tell you, you talk to guys who have fished with it and pros that have fished with the Deathgrip Jighead, they will tell you it is the best one on the market.
Oh, there we go.
There, you got it.
Dude, if it was warmer, we'd be smashing these fish right now.
But it's incredible that we're catching them. I mean, it really is. I mean, with the way the weather is right now,
water mid-50s, and we're catching good-sized trout, too.
Yep. But, you know, we talked about it a little earlier. You know, when we were in the room today, we were doing, like, a little pre-tease about this thing, and I said, it's not going to be easy. It's going to be a long day, and we're going to have to fish today.
Yeah.
Because of just the conditions we have. But, you know, sometimes it's fun to go out. It's fun to catch them every cast, but sometimes it's fun to go out and have to work for them. You know, absolutely. People don't think that's fun, but sometimes it is. You know, it's kind of a battle between you and the fish. You know, are they going to be here? Are they going to be here? How are they going to bite? So that's how it's been for us today. It hasn't been easy so far, but as the water temperature and the wind has died down, I can tell you that the bite has picked up significantly here in the last few minutes, and hopefully it'll stay that way.
Yep. As the day has gone and developed, that cloud bank has pushed off and the sun's come out, these fish are starting to wake up a little bit, starting to warm up. So hopefully it continues.
Yeah, it's knock on wood, my head.
There he is.
Got it?
Yep.
Now, Wayne, the pattern that we're using right now is a typical springtime pattern. We're on power pole right now, but this is basically a drift fishing type of deal we're doing.
Absolutely. We kind of drifted a little bit till we got into a few of them, and when we caught a few, put the power poles down, and it's been, you know, fairly consistent. So,
but don't think that you're going to sit and catch 100 of them in one spot. That's not going to happen.
No.
Especially on a day like today. So, you go as soon as you catch a fish, R2, put the power pole down. When it stops, drift a little bit.
Yep.
You just can't sit on anchor the whole time. Oh, I got another trout.
There you go. They're starting to turn on.
Oh, I got another trout. And this is a nice one.
Uh-huh. There's some pretty fish right here.
Yeah, some pretty fish. This one is a nice one. See who's casting in my spot now. Look at this trout, y'all. Look at this trout.
You want me to net it?
Yeah, get the net. Yeah, let's get the net for this one. Yeah, I don't net many of them, but that's net worthy there. Oh yeah, I would say that's a net worthy trout.
Absolutely. Check that big boy out.
Yeah. You don't think we have some nice ones down here? That's nice. Wow. So trout fishing this time of year, if it's cold in the morning, sleep or go get breakfast. Because at some point, these are gonna bite. You got him though. That Lane's got one. Come on up. There you go.
There we go.
So Lane, what do you think it is that makes your that ghost minnow so effective?
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchtone Energy Cooperative.
The way the little ghost minnow is shaped, it's a real tough plastic, but if you shake that little tail, it's got a lot of action to it. So when you pop it underneath this cork, that tail is going nuts under there. And trout really, really like it.
You know, and a lot of people think, have a perception, that you need to fish a paddle tail bait under a cork. Very rarely are you seeing people fish, for the majority of the time, they're always fishing a paddle tail under the cork. They think that's kind of the best way to fish them, but that's not the case. They are going to hit those straight tail baits under a cork as long as they have that action.
Yep. I rarely ever fish a paddle tail bait under a cork. I just feel that's not the right application for that bait. I usually tight line and, you know, put it on, spin a bait and stuff like that, where that little tail needs to do its thing. When you're popping it under a cork, that bait just needs to flutter and dart. So you really don't need a paddle tail under a cork. These little straight tail baits do an excellent job for that.
They really do. Mm-hmm. So try that ghost minnow under a cork. It's very effective.
Get him, Kevin, though. Get him.
I didn't miss mine. And we have been pretty lucky right here. We just kind of pulled probably a dozen fish out of this spot on PowerPoint. And again, the leeches, you can just tell they've been on the bottom, sitting there. Mm-hmm. But they are starting to eat. And normally when it warms up after a front, these fish are going to get hungry and move around and want to eat.
Absolutely. You can kind of tell how we've been fishing. Some have come off of the left side of the boat, some are in front of the boat, some on the right side. They kind of roaming around this little flat that we're on, so we're kind of catching them fan casting. But they're here, they're just moving around trying to get themselves going.
And that's a good thing. We're getting ourselves going too. We may be shedding jackets in a few minutes, which I didn't think that was going to happen earlier this morning. Oh God, you saw him? It was a redfish.
Hit the cork?
Yeah,
I got you.
I don't know if that was a redfish or a trout, but he hit
the cork.
Dude,
if it was a trout that hit that cork, it's a monster.
It's not that big of a fish, but it was a trout that hit the cork. Did you see that?
Uh-huh.
I mean, he hit the cork. This fish hit the cork. There's no way that's the fish that hit the cork. No way.
Can't be.
Uh-uh.
He must have been hanging out with a big redfish.
Yeah, he was hanging out with a big redfish because the redfish hit the cork. I can promise you that trout didn't make that much of a noise. Well, I saw that cork get hit. I was like, uh-oh, here we go with a big redfish. But hey, I'll take the speckled trout instead. Having fun. Come down here, book a trip with Captain Lane. Catch you some of these. Maybe not. Maybe not. Tell you what, I've been doing a pretty good job of getting them off that one little spot. Just casting right in front of the boat. 3 feet of water, 2 feet under a cork, and that's been the ticket. Another one. Gotta love it. And that little tail right there makes all the difference in the world. You know, when you talk about Delacroix, and there's all kind of little lakes like this. I mean, this isn't the only place you can fish, and that's
the
thing about it. I mean, there's so many places that are just like we're in right now where you can catch fish, and that's what makes it so special.
Yeah, there's 100 other little lakes like this that if there's grass and there's bait there, there's bound to be fish there. So you have a ton of options coming fish down here.
Yeah, I mean, and like we said, if you know you have grass, if you know there's been grass, no matter what the water condition, no matter what the water looks like, fish it. You may catch trout. I would have never in a million years thought we were going to catch a speckled trout here in this filthy water. And this water is filthy dirty, and we're fishing plastic. We're not fishing live shrimp, and we're catching fish. So it just tells you that if you know there's an area with bait and grass, fish it, period.
Yep.
And
can't go wrong.
Can't go wrong. ATV is brought to you by the Chandelier Islander Fishing Lodge, full service, all-inclusive meals and lodging in the heart of the Chandelier Islands. Come stay and play in paradise. There we go. That's a good one.
That's a pretty fish.
That's a pretty one. Now we made the drift again, started drifting up a little bit more. Because we probably caught 15, 20 fish off that one spot. So what do? Make a little move.
And get back on them.
Nice one.
Solid fish.
But yeah, you just stay on them as long as you're getting bites. When you go 10 or 15 minutes without a bite, just start drifting again. And then sometimes, if you're in a really good spot, what you're going to want to do is just make that same drift over and over. So there's options that you can do, but just don't sit and wait. And don't be afraid to go back and forth over the same spot if you need to. Because those fish are just scattered out all here. We showed you the fish on the bottom. We showed you the leeches on them. They're not just moving everywhere. They're not overly aggressive because they're still on the bottom. So drift, move, stop, but don't sit forever. Well, after a very cold and slow start, this turned out to be an amazing day of fishing. And well, we caught some really big speckled trout on the inside. And our thanks to Captain Lane Zimmer Jr. with Marsh Monkeys Guide Service What a great day. Give him a call and book a trip and come down here to St. Bernard Parish. Thanks to Captain Jack Payne at Sweetwater Marina for the lodging. And we want you to come to St. Bernard Parish, and to learn more about everything you can do down here, go to visitstbernard.com and book a fishing trip, and you will have a great time. Great fishing, great food, great culture, all right here. For Captain Lane Zimmer and producer Jim Caesar, I'm Kevin Ford. Thanks so much for watching today, and we'll see you next week right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.